days, my friend.
Hey, Star Wars fans. Welcome to BNN. My name is Ben. You're probably not the only ones who were confused as to how the Emperor returns. I'm confused, too. I mean, this isn't the MCU where no matter how dead you are,
Vision,
no matter how choked to death you are,
Loki,
for some reason you have a new series coming out in 2021. Like, dude, didn't Thanos totally rip Vision's head apart like a freaking banana like 1 year ago? Oh, did I mention his girlfriend blew him up first? Then Thanos gave him the most brutal incision in brain surgery history. Damn.
That's just lazy writing.
In Return of the Jedi, this man, the Emperor, got picked up, body slammed into a bottomless pit. Wasn't really much of a body slam, actually. Vader's suit was so tight, I don't even know how he even lifted the Emperor up that high without hearing the sound of his undershirt ripping. Old movies. Then guess what? His body got blown up, nuclear style. There's no way he survived that, my guy. Some of us had a theory that perhaps he will be resurrected in some weird Frankenstein monster way. And some of us assumed he would return in the form of a ghost and take on a new human form. But even as powerful as Palpatine was, he did not have the capability to resurrect himself. So J.J. Abrams has found a way to revive him in a storyline that makes logical sense. Heck, the title shouldn't be The Rise of Skywalker. It should be
Star Wars: The Rise of Wrinkled Face.
Anyway, we got this covered reported that according to the same sources who told us Ewan McGregor, I can never pronounce the guy's name, was returning as Obi-Wan Kenobi, and that the leads in Ghostbusters 3 would be young teens, both of which have since been confirmed. All those ideas about Palpatine somehow being resurrected are wrong. Instead, the villain will actually be revealed to have survived his fall at Darth Vader's hand in Return of the Jedi.
Damn, that's just cheap, bro.
Anyway, it goes on to say he only just escaped death. However, as he's been apparently been in hiding ever since, healing and recovering. During his period in hiding, he'll also have built a new army of red stormtroopers, the Sith troopers we've previously seen. I do have one problem with this leak, though. How could the Emperor have survived if whatever pit he fell in was attached to the Death Star and he was in space? And the ship blew up, remember? Anyway, apparently his mission will be to use Kylo Ren to bring Rey to the dark side. Yeah, the same Kylo Ren who just got his ass beat by a woman who barely knows the true ways of the Force twice and Luke's Force ghost. I mean, he's not really a villain. He's more like a whiny baby brat who dresses like he can fight. Like, guys, he looked way more badass with that mask, though. What the hell did y'all do with his mask? It was so cool. And he seemed more of a bad guy as opposed to now. He looks and acts like a nerd whose family gave him away to a foster home when he turned 3, and that's why he has a bunch of anger issues. No matter how interesting all of this may seem, I can't say my expectations for this movie are high, because ever since George Lucas sold all of Lucasfilm to Disney for more than $4 billion in 2012, I really wasn't expecting the new trilogy to make the same impact, and my suspicions were correct. We also got news from Art Tavana of MTV that the Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is currently undergoing reshoots, and that some said George Lucas has been begged to offer insight, and that it looks like there may be trouble with the film. I'll tell you what I'm begging for. I'm begging for Doctor Strange to give me the time stone so I can go back to 2015 and burn J.J. Abrams' script for The Last Jedi a day before they started casting. Maybe I should have asked Thanos to just use the stones 3 years early so he could turn that script to dust. There is one plot twist that has been on everybody's mind, though. Is Rey the daughter of the Emperor? Comment down below with your thoughts, and remember, the prophecy of the Chosen One who would destroy the Sith and bring balance to the Force. Looks like they lied, because their Chosen One clearly failed. There was nothing more he could do anyway. I mean, this old wrinkled face fell down for who knows how long. Maybe 30 minutes.
I have been falling for 30 minutes!
If you like what you see and you want to see more, don't forget to like and subscribe to Comic Book Lab for more amazing content. And as always, in the loving memory of Tony Stark, I love you 3000.